I have a right shirt, and as you can tell, I have a right shirt.
Question. Beautiful.
Question. When we last spoke, it was when Julio Cesar Jr. was fighting Andrew Fonfara, and you told me then in Montreal, for you, watching his son fight is a lot more nervous than whenever you were watching. It is still the case.
Julio le pregunta al señor que cuando peleó, que la última vez que habló con usted, que cuando peleó Junior con Fonfara, que usted le comentó que era más, que usted se ponía más nervioso viendo a sus hijos pelear que cuando usted peleaba. ¿Todavía sigue siendo el caso?
Dile que los hijos, Silva, ahí no se ve. Dile que los hijos cuando crecen ya no hacen caso, dile. En este caso, Julio, cuando peleó con Fonfara, yo no quería que peleara con Fonfara porque era un peso que no era de él. Ahora va con esta leyenda de las artes marciales, Anthony Silva, va en un peso también que no es de él. Pero pues el coche sí es, ¿no? Julio se está preparando para una pelea complicada, una pelea difícil. Aunque Anthony Silva, pues no es boxeador profesional, pero creo que es una pelea difícil, complicada.
Yeah, he said that unfortunately, when you know kids grow up, they don't listen to their advice and you know, to their parents' advice anymore. They think they know everything. And when he fought Fonfara, he was going on a weight that wasn't his, and he wasn't okay with it. And now they still. But even though he's not a boxer, he's also fighting. He agreed to a weight that was a little bit higher, and you know. But it is what it is, but yes, he still gets nervous.
I'm gonna ask you the questions regarding you, because from everything we can say about you, those 115 fights, those unbelievable fights, for me still. The biggest thing when talking about the legend like you are is 37 championship fights. Nobody even comes closer to 37 championship fights like you did. What was the state of mind to be ready always for those championship fights?
Le pregunta que de sus 150 peleas, una carrera increíble, 37 campeonatos. ¿Qué era su estado mental para poder aguantar tantas peleas y tantas peleas de campeonato?
Bueno, dile que fue algo, al principio de mi carrera fue algo pues fácil para mí, pero cuando ya yo llegué a 90 peleas invicto, pues yo sentí que lo había ganado todo y yo empecé a descuidarme. Y empezaron a venir las derrotas. Pero yo creo que si yo hubiera sido un peleador, fui un peleador disciplinado, pero como te digo, ya llegaron 90 peleas, yo ya sentí que lo había ganado todo. Y fue cuando empecé a descuidarme, fue cuando caí pues, en el problema que todo mundo sabe, en el alcohol y las drogas, y fue cuando empezaron a venir las derrotas. Pero yo creo que si yo me hubiera preparado siempre, como lo hice siempre al principio de mi carrera, yo hubiera llegado a 100 peleas invicto sin ningún problema.
Yeah, so he says that, you know, at the beginning it was easy. He was disciplined. Once he got to 90 fights, unbeaten, he felt like he had it all. He had accomplished it all. So he kind of started letting his guard down. And once his guard started coming down, you know, everybody knows his issues that he had with addiction and you know, drugs and alcohol. And unfortunately, you know, that's when the losses started coming. But he feels that if he would have kept his state of mind and the discipline, you know, that he would have gotten to 100 fights easy without losing.
Very interesting.
Entonces, dile que si yo me hubiera cuidado como lo hice al principio de mi carrera, como dije, no hubiera sido el mejor peleador mexicano de todos los tiempos, sino el mejor peleador mexicano de la historia, porque imagínate si hubiera llegado a 100 peleas invicto, pues sería algo grandioso que nadie lo podía repetir.
Yeah, he says that if he would have stuck with that discipline and with that mindset, you know, that hunger, you know, that he had before his at his 90 fights unbeaten, he wouldn't have only been the Gran Campeón Mexicano. He would have been the best fighter in the world ever, you know, to be able to get to 100 fights without losing.
I think so. You still are. I mean, I was in Dallas when Canelo fought BJ Saunders. I was sitting in the press row, just maybe, I don't know, 50 feet from there, 25 feet from the ring, and you were on the left side. Whenever you showed up, the fans were drawing to you like nothing else I ever saw it. And it's always when you show up. And then we had the Canelo saying that he never wants to be, paraphrasing, he never wanna be another Julio Cesar Chavez, because there's gonna be never another Julio Cesar Chavez. So this is one of the biggest things you can hear from the right now, the best fighter in the world. How do you take this honor, getting those words from Canelo Alvarez?
Primeramente le dice Julio que todavía lo es usted el gran y que no va a haber otro como usted. Dice que él estuvo en la pelea de Canelo a 25 pies de ahí del ring cuando usted entró, y cuando usted entra toda la gente se va con usted y las fotos y autógrafos y todo, a saludarle, todo, y mismo Canelo lo dijo, que nunca iba a haber otro peleador como usted. Escuchando estas palabras del peleador del momento, se puede decir, y viendo la reacción de la afición, como en donde quiera que se para usted, pues, ¿cómo se siente y qué piensa usted de eso?
Dile que la verdad, me siento muy bendecido por Dios. Dile que a pesar de todas mis adicciones que pasé, la gente nunca dejó de quererme. La gente, lo único que recibo son puras bendiciones de toda la gente donde me paro. Y es increíble, dile que hay una frase, dile que de José Alfredo Jiménez, que gané mucho dinero, gané muchos títulos mundiales, gané muchos campeonatos mundiales, soy el que tiene más peleas de campeonato mundial, y eso va a pasar, dile. Pero lo que nunca va a pasar es que nadie va a tener el cariño y el afecto de todos los mexicanos como lo tengo yo.
So he says that he feels very blessed by God. You know, everything that his addiction took him to, and that he was able to get out of it, and everything after that has been nothing but blessings. And even more so that through his addiction and through all his problems that he had, coming out on the other side, people just love him that much more. You know, and there's, he says that there will be money and there will be championships and countless belts and everything, but those will come and go. And he says that will never leave him is the fans' love and the love that that his country has for him.
I completely agree. I mean, whatever money you're gonna make, you can spend it, but the history it stays behind you. The history, it's about legacy, it's about history. Before we go to the fight with Macho Jr., I know you beat the father about 30 years ago. Question about, people ask me when I told people I'm gonna interview legendary Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., they told me, they asked me to ask you the question, what was your best fight? Because there's millions of options. I mean, for me, it's the Rosario fight, the one of the most unbelievable fights I ever saw it, and I saw it thousands of them. But is it the fight that you thought the people are underappreciating maybe better than Rosario fight, or what's you? When were you the best of your life? Which fight was the best fight you ever fought?
Primeramente dice que pues que está 100% de acuerdo con usted en cuanto a lo que dijo del dinero y todo eso y va y viene y la el cariño de su gente, 100% están de acuerdo con usted. Se trata de su legado que usted va a dejar, de ese cariño que toda la gente le tiene. Le pregunta para usted cuál fue la mejor pelea. Dice que para él la mejor pelea de usted fue contra Rosario, pero usted, ¿cuál fue su donde usted sintió que fue su mejor pelea?
Sí, mira, dile que definitivamente cuando peleé con Rosario, pues no me ganaba nadie. Con todo respeto, no me ganaba nadie. Pero la pelea más mediática que ha habido en la historia en México, sobre todo, donde todo México se paralizó, fue con Macho Camacho. Entonces, esa pelea fue una verdadera locura y no se ha vuelto a repetir, donde todo México se paralizó para ver esa pelea. Entonces, cuando me propusieron hacer la exhibición con Macho Camacho Jr., la verdad no acepté porque es mucho más joven que yo, mucho más pesado que yo, pero como yo le tuve un gran respeto y un gran cariño a Macho Camacho, acepté este compromiso, que la verdad, con todo respeto, me ha costado muchísimo trabajo, porque estoy preparándome como si fuera para una pelea. Aparte, me voy a quitar la careta en el último round para darle ese gran espectáculo a toda la gente que me va a ver, sobre todo ahí en a todos mis paisanos en Estados Unidos, que la compren por pay-per-view, y acá en el Estadio Jalisco, pues a pesar de la pandemia, yo creo que va a haber un lleno a reventar.
So he says that when he fought against Rosario, that with all due respect to every fighter, he says he felt unbeatable. He felt that nobody can beat him, nobody could touch him. It was a tough fight, but he felt strong. He felt mentally strong. Everything, he was just unbeatable at that point. And when he fought Camacho, he said that was probably like his best fight, because he in all aspects, physically, mentally. You know, for fans, for everything, it was a fight that basically paralyzed Mexico. Businesses shut down. The stadium was completely full. You know, so that for him was his biggest fight and his biggest success. And that's why he accepted this fight against Camacho Jr. When the idea was presented to him, he decided to take it out of the respect and out of the love that he has for Camacho, because after the fight with Camacho Sr., they became really good friends and had a lot of love for each other. So that's why he accepted this fight against Camacho. And he says that he wants to give the fans a treat for them to see him the last time in the ring. All that love that the fans have given him throughout the years, this is to give back to them.
Sí, aparte dile que esto ya se salió de control, dile, porque pues ya Camacho Jr. está empezando a hablar que me va a arrancar la cabeza, que va a vengar a su padre, y entonces pues yo he tomado las cosas con mucha seriedad. Aparte me voy a quitar la careta, como te digo, un último round para darle pues lo que la gente quiere, ¿me entiendes? Que vean al gran campeón mexicano pelear por última vez sin careta con el hijo de Macho Camacho, y sea lo que Dios quiera. Es por eso que me estoy preparando como si fuera para una pelea, y yo creo que con todo respeto, Camacho ya está hablando mucho, le voy a pegar una chinga como se la pegué a su papá.
Okay, he says that, he says that he wants to give the fans one last show, even if it's just a glimpse of what he is or what he was. He says his fight has gotten a little bit out of control. Junior's talking a lot of shit, saying that this is revenge for his dad, and that he's gonna beat him for his dad.
Sí, porque él dice que él va a tratar de vengar a su padre, y yo creo que él va a salir con todo, y como me voy a quitar la careta en ese último round, pues en ese último round él va a tratar de noquearme, y yo también, va a ser como una pelea formal.
So yeah, so he says that this, even though it's an exhibition, this has turned into into an actual fight. At first it was all fun and games, but now, you know, he's saying that he's gonna knock him out. Camacho Jr. saying that he's gonna come after him. It's a revenge, his opportunity for revenge. He's waited so many years for this. And so Julio says that he's gonna go out to no mercy, and he's gonna give him a beating just like he gave his dad.
Fantastic. But you know what? Two more questions. From the beginning I didn't believe it's just some kind of exhibition fight for you, because you always fight 100%. So I didn't see you like pull the punches. If you want to punch someone, Julio Cesar Chavez punches the guy. I mean, always was like that. But this was you just answered my question. So you're gonna be the best you can be, being you are almost my age. You are actually a year younger. So I understand. I wasn't a fighter, never even close to you or anything like that. But I understand it's different. But the mind stays the same, Julio. You still when you go into the ring, the blood is buzzing, and you just wanna show the other guy that you are the better one.
Le pregunta a Julio si que él sabe, conociéndolo a usted y viendo su carrera y siempre viendo todo lo que usted ha hecho, que él, desde que escuchó esto, que él sabía que no iba a ser una simple exhibición. Sabía que conforme se fueran calentando las cosas, que usted iba a salir a lo que es una pelea y no se iba a detener de sus golpes, nada, que le iba a dar con todo a Camacho. Entonces, conociendo su mentalidad de usted de campeón y fuerte, qué es lo que va a hacer usted en el ring con Camacho.
Bueno, mira, efectivamente, mira, una pelea que es exhibición, pero ¿cuál exhibición? Ya estando arriba del ring, uno se calienta, ¿me entiendes? Aparte, Camacho está hablando mucha mierda ya, ¿me entiendes? Dice que va a vengar a su padre, que me va a noquear. Los primeros 4 rounds van a ser con careta, y en el último round vamos a salir a noquearnos. ¿Me noquea él o lo noqueo yo, me entiendes? Yo quiero que quede ese recuerdo en todos los hispanos allá, a todos mis paisanos allá en Estados Unidos que van a comprar la pelea por pay-per-view, decirles que les voy a regalar 5 rounds, pero 5 rounds, lógicamente, ya no con la misma velocidad, ya no con lo mismo del gran campeón mexicano, pero con lo que tengo todavía, mis 58 años, me alcanza para pegarle una chinga a Camacho y a muchos más.
He says that, he says, obviously, we start off as an exhibition, but as things get heated, it turns into a real fight, and he's not pulling any punches. He's out to knock him out. He says he wants to knock him out. It's getting out of hand. He's talking a lot of shit, saying he's going to knock him out. So as things get heated, you know, Camacho Jr. is talking about vengeance, and Julio knows that he's not on that level anymore, you know, when he was young. But he says that no matter what, maybe he doesn't have the same speed, but with what he has, he says he can put a beating on Junior and a few more guys that are still fighting. So he wants to give his fans one last, you know how they say, one last hurrah. He's going to give them 4 rounds of with his headgear on, and the last round he's going to take his headgear off. So either Camacho Jr. will get knocked out, or he'll get knocked out. One of the two.
Man, sí, dile que la chinga que le voy a dar en ese último round, nadie se lo va a quitar, dile.
The beating that's going to put on Camacho Jr., no money, no person, no nurse, nobody's going to be able to take away from him.
Aparte, dile que ese quinto round se lo voy a dedicar a todos mis paisanos en Estados Unidos. Por eso digo que compren el pay-per-view. Porque ese quinto round se lo voy a dedicar a todos mis paisanos y a todo Jalisco.
He says that the last round, that's why he's taking off his headgear. He's dedicating that round to all the Mexican people that are in, to all his fans that are in the United States, that are, you know, away from their homes, and to all the fans of Jalisco and the city of Guadalajara. That's why he decided to take off his face mask in the last round. So buy, so that's what he's saying, buy the pay-per-view. Make sure that everybody buys the pay-per-view because they're going to see El Gran Campeón Mexicano for the last time in the ring, fifth round without no headgear. So either Camacho's going to get knocked out or Chavez is going to get knocked out, one of the two. But the beating that he's going to lay on him, no one's ever going to take it away from him.
Thank you very much. It was always a pleasure to talk to the legend. You didn't change. I saw the interviews when you were 25, when you were 30. You are slightly older now, but it's still the same inside Julio Cesar Chavez, the legend. Thank you very much, and have fun. Absolutely, have fun there.
Dile que me despido con una frase. A todos mis paisanos en Estados Unidos que van a comprar Pelén, pay-per-view, decirles thank you very much, I love you too much, I love you too chingo. Gracias por todo. 19 de junio, pay-per-view.
Thank you.
Do I have to translate?
Okay, thank you.
he loves his fans, he loves everybody, and he just wants to get everybody a great show.